me this morning from Chaarat Gold. I'm joined by Artem Volynets. Artem, good morning.
Good morning.
Look, we've always known Chaarat's an ambitious company. I think the news this week around the $2 billion bid for Centerra came as a bit of a surprise to some. Was it a serious offer?
Of course, it was a serious proposal. The size of the transaction doesn't matter as long as there is enough returns available for investors to make from such a transaction. Centerra is a classic breakup situation, which if you separate what you call apple from oranges, the asset in emerging markets, in a more risky jurisdiction such as Kumtor, from the rest of the portfolio, which is assets in developed markets, you can release substantial amount of value. So there are always investment appetite for this type of transactions, provided they're done on a friendly basis.
And this was an all-cash offer, I believe, was it?
That's correct. We believe there is enough investment appetite for this deal. And very simply, Centerra is now trading at roughly half of its net asset value. So even if you offer a significant premium, you'll be buying assets at around below NAV. So if you separate Kumtor, which is an asset that we are interested in, and put the rest of the portfolio on auction, which was done a few years ago, you can extract significant price for that. That was our logic, and we had discussions with finance providers who were ready to support this proposal, provided it's done on a friendly basis. And we hoped that Centerra management would get involved with us to discuss such a proposal, because in our view, it did make sense for Centerra shareholders, for our shareholders, and for the Kyrgyz government. Well, that hasn't happened. It's out of our hands now. We are busy executing on our strategy of consolidating the gold sector in the former Soviet Union.
Because, of course, this was at a 35% premium to the share price at the time as well.
Well, between our first offer in March and our second proposal in September, Centerra share price went down by 30%.
Right. Just remind us why you wanted the Kumtor mine? Why was it attractive?
Because our strategy is very simple. We embarked on consolidating the gold sector in the former Soviet Union. There is a significant industrial logic in combining our operations in Kyrgyz Republic with Kumtor gold mine. And we thought that if you'd buy it at a good price, it would make sense for Centerra shareholders. That would make sense for the Kyrgyz government, who would get direct access to the cash flows. Would make sense for our shareholders. But there are another 25 to 30 different assets in that part of the world that we should be looking at and that we're actively pursuing. So with or without Kumtor, we're still going to do our execute on our strategy.
So this is the end of the road then? You're no longer looking at the Kumtor mine?
That's not a question for us. You should be asking that question to Centerra.
Are you optimistic at all?
I'm very optimistic in our ability to execute our strategy at valuations and prices which are attractive to our shareholders.
And so tell me a little bit more about the Kapan mining then. That was announced this week.
That's right. That's a good example of what I just said. So Chaarat is a small, humble organization with excellent teams that we put together. Kapan mine that we are buying from Polymetal, we announced this transaction this week. We're buying it for roughly 2x EBITDA, so it's a very attractive price. In comparison, there is another company on other side of the Atlantic called Barrick that is buying Rand Gold. But the difference between us and them is not in the relative sizes, but in the prices that we are paying. Barrick is buying Rand Gold is over 8x EBITDA. 8.2.
So a good deal?
It's an excellent deal and also demonstrates our ability to execute deals diligently and quickly. We signed term sheet for Kapan acquisition within 10 days with engagement with the vendor. We signed definitive documents within 3 months, and we're working on 3 other transactions at the moment, none of which is Kumtor. So other deals that we are planning to execute next year.
This Kapan mining, $55 million in cash. How's that being funded?
First of all, five million of that is taken by Polymetal in the form of our convertible bond. So Polymetal becomes our investor, which I'm very pleased with, because that's one of the best and well-run companies in our sector, in our region. So they express confidence in our story by taking our paper. The rest will be funded from cash, from proceeds of the debt funding that we'll put at the asset level, as well as proceeds of our convertible bond issue.
I think a little earlier on this year, when you first had your eye on Kumtor and you made an offer, that's when shares in Chaarat were suspended.
That's correct.
Right. Given you're no longer at this stage considering Kumtor, when can we expect shares to be readmitted?
I hope as soon as practical. We are taking Chaarat back to the markets for the readmission. We'll publish readmission documents hopefully soon. That will include the description of new Chaarat, which is now becoming a producer from the developer, with three mines, one in Armenia and two in Kyrgyz Republic. So multi-assets, multi-jurisdiction platform. That is the beginning of the platform that we want to build.
And quite a new management team as well.
That's right. We changed all of the management team at the holdco level. We are very happy with the talent that we attracted, and it's what we call an IKEA type setup. We pay ourselves very little, and we are motivated on the upside.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned a moment ago you've got three other deals that you're looking at.
That's correct.
Is there more you can tell me about them?
Obviously, I will not be able to do that at this stage, but as soon as we make an announcement, I'm happy to come back here.
Look forward to it. What about Tuklbash? What's happening here?
We published the resource update, if you may remember, in September. On the basis of that, we are going to publish a reserve update pretty soon. We continue drilling, and that will lead to another resource and reserves update in the early part of the next year.
And still targeting production in 2020?
That's correct. Our target is at least 100,000 ounces on a full run rate, starting production in 2020. It's a relatively simple operation. We are planning to do a heap leach facility, as we discussed before, at a cost of $130 million, most of which will be funded from the project finance facility. So the plan there, we'll finish drilling this year, get resource and reserve update, and then start discussions with the project finance providers.
Those discussions you'd like to start at some point mid-next year, would you?
Early next year.
Early next year?
Yeah, with Chaarat is a fast-running horse. We have to run fast.
Certainly. And Kyrgyzstan?
We're doing metallurgical testing there. It's a very attractive but a complex ore body, which is refractory ore, so we need to understand what is the best process from extracting gold. We're not there yet, but we're making good progress.
Well, a fast-running horse, as you described it a moment ago, and clearly you're not afraid to go chasing what you're after. You got big ambitions.
We are motivated on a goal, and we're very excited about building what we believe is going to be one of the leading emerging market gold companies.
Artem, always good to see you. Thanks for your time.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.